Harold Miner. And the juggernaut, Randy Reed.
Question, and here's number six right there, although Mitchell gets it back, looking for Miner down low. Shaquille for two.
They get it inside to the power slam jam bammer. See, Shaquille Key really right now.
Bray has it blocked by O'Neal. Loose, they let him play in the middle out of the pack. Jackson up ahead, Miner. Miner, a nice move, and that's going to be a goaltend on Barnes.
Harold Miner's a prolific scorer, outstanding young man going down to Southern Cal, playing for George Raveling. Probably the biggest recruit that he's gotten since he's been at Southern Cal. There he is, from out of L.A., and here's the goaltending. Miner is really going to be a great help to Raveling's team. He started to improve down the stretch. If you look at Bart Schroeder, big year coming up for George Raveling. They got
the heel got there for a block. Get away in the back, move to Jackson. Miner, left-hander for two.
Harold Miner, I'll tell you one thing, they're going to love him down versus Southern Cal. He'll be a prolific scorer. Anthony Pendleton came on strong at the end of the year. It's been a disappointment, but the two of them should give a lot of point production to George Raveling's team.
McCaffrey takes the pull-off. Miner got a piece of it. Loose ball. Look at the scoring leaders from the first half. It was Shaquille up top there with 10, and James Robinson out of Mississippi 10, and then quite a drop-off. You see a mix.
Even though we had the charter, it was an awful lot of money, and on short notice, when you don't know something like that's going to happen, you don't have the money put aside, and they had to watch on TV, which is great, thank God for that, but you would think maybe in an NCAA tournament, you might be able to make something, maybe aside, and they had to watch on TV, which is great, thank God for that, but you would think...
It's going to be great for basketball.
And it's going to eliminate some of those Twinkies that guys like to play. I wouldn't say Boeheim likes to play the Portland State and all. I promise I wouldn't say that. Hey, PJ, thanks a lot for joining us.
Big thank you, Michael. Great to be
top with the Pittsburgh fans. Then the other thing that really made it was in the early days we had great local players, more so than in recent years. Kenny Durrett, Maurice Lucas. Having people come in like a seven-footer like Jim McShane, knowing who's next. Who are the next kids that Dick Vitale and Mike are going to be talking about when you come to the NCAA tournament? And this is what it's all about.
Jim, we want to really thank you for joining us for a moment. Certainly, Street & Smith's one of the great magazines, but you watch out. There's another magazine called Dick Vitale, so we're going to catch you.
Well, you're pushing real hard, but we're still number one, and we want to stay there.
Well, we try harder. Thanks a lot, Jim.
Thanks for coming by and joining us here. 4:15 left to go in the game, 92-69. East on top, Harold Miner, who will be headed to the University of Southern California at the line. Edward, the leading scorer in the game right now, he's got 21, and Shaquille O'Neal leading the West, he's got 19.
They really got off to that poor start. You can't spot a club 20 zip and give them that kind of confidence and be able to...
Final 15 seconds now. Bruce McCray has not had a good dunking night tonight. It's been a struggle for Conrad on the jam. Miner sends down what perhaps will be the final 2 points of the game. And the East doesn't reach the 100 mark, but a very, very convincing win for Coach Bob Hurley and Marco Rodriguez as their club wins it here tonight in the 25th Dapper Dan Classic, 96-84, the final score. 10-point win for the East. We'll be back with some final words here from Pittsburgh in just a minute.